Hey everyone, this is Ferret, and welcome to the third part of my Let's Play of Sonic the Hedgehog. Before I begin, we normally have level challenges for the second and third acts of each zone, but here we actually got a zone challenge from Spoonman Abrams, and it was to finish each level with an increasingly higher number of rings. Technically, the original wording said to collect that many, but in order to be able to actually track the challenge, I changed it to route to finish. Hopefully that means the same thing as what he intended, if not, I hope he likes the challenge anyways. Anyways, this is the Spring Yard zone, which is personally one of my favorite zones in the game. It's casino themed, it's structured somewhat like a pinball table, but without the actual flippers. It's very fun. There's lots of speed, there's plenty of ramps or secrets hidden in those gated vent areas down there. There's some clever enemies. It's just a really fun zone. Very user friendly, not too difficult, I like it. I take the switch up here because it's a much more interesting path up here, whereas down there there's more spikes and it's not too interesting. And I want my Let's Play to be entertaining, so I'll show you guys the cool parts of this level. Now coming up here, you're actually going to see a couple of, like, computer terms, up, next, or excuse me, on, and CPU, which stands for Central Processing Unit. And some other parts of the level, you also see COPE, which I looked up what it meant, and it was apparently a development term. So, woohoo, inside computer jokes. Exciting, no? Anyways, we got the Buzz Bombers which return here. These creatures, the purple ones are called Spikes. That is actually their name, I'm not kidding. They're kind of like the Caterkillers, in that they have a smaller hit radius this time though, but they don't break into pieces if you mess up incorrectly. There's Rollers, which was that thing that kind of looked like Sonic the Hedgehog earlier on. It rolls around and mimics his behavior in jumping, although it's not a hedgehog, obviously. The crabs are crab meat. Not really sure why they're called crab meat, because you don't eat them, and they're robots. Robots cannot be meat, that makes no sense. Anyways, next act. We have a level challenge from Alpha Unit, which was to play through an entire level with only one hand on the keyboard. Since this is mostly post-commentary, I can't show you exactly what it looked like, but I can try and illustrate it. We're also continuing the zone challenge, because I got 12 in the previous act. Basically, I had one pinky, like, barely touching the directional pads on my keyboard, and the other was touching the jump areas. I'm playing this game on Steam, that's why I'm using a keyboard. It actually wasn't too difficult to do, because the actual stage isn't too long, but it does take a while to get used to. That was an example of one of the secret gate areas I was talking about. They're hidden throughout this level, some have items, some have rings, and a few have alternate paths. Down there, there's a blue shield, but I don't want to go there because it wastes too much time, because it's basically bumper hell. There's no threat down there, but it takes absolutely forever to get in there and then to get out. Man, I'm not doing well with the spikes in this level, I apologize. But I'll get the challenges done though, you'll see. Spring Yard Zone was actually intended to be the fifth zone in this game originally. It was the first one to be completely developed. Its background appears in Sonic Drift, which is that racing game I was talking about earlier. This is also one of the only two zones in Sonic the Hedgehog history to have two different exits. Like, if you go up there and jump off the ramp, you'll get a similar exit to this one with a lot of hidden rings around. The other one is in Collision Chaos in Sonic CD. Anyways, I need to get 20 rings to finish this challenge. Not too hard, because I need to hold them onto them with the boss at the end, so that might be kind of tricky. Again, I just really like the zone. Lots of secrets. Down there, there's 10 rings hidden in there. I don't want to waste too much time though, because then I have to go on these boxes again. Which this is the only part I don't like about the level, the boxes. Not because there's challenge, there's no challenge. You're actually pretty easy unless you're impatient and get crushed between them. But because it's like, you sit there for over 10 seconds, there's not really a whole lot happening, it's kind of a waste of time, I'm not a big fan of them. I like the rest of this level, even this kind of annoying part right here. Because if you get hit by those spikes, then because of momentum and physics, then you're bound to keep getting hit, and that's really annoying if you try and get the Chaos Emeralds, because you need 50 rings or more with Giant Rings. I don't do the special stages in this Let's Play, I did one at the beginning to show what it was like, because they're kind of time consuming. I'm not sure if people would be interested in them. If you are, then leave a comment below and I might make a bonus video at the end of this Let's Play of those special stages. But otherwise, we're just gonna keep going. These half pipes are really fun. You can gain lots of momentum. It kind of reminds me of like a skateboarding game, sort of. Even though there's not a spin dash yet, it's just really fun. And now we have both invincibility and super speed. So Blast Processing has evolved into Super Blast Processing. If you played Sonic the Hedgehog 2 and unlocked Supersonic with all the Chaos Emeralds, this is what it would be like. You have double speed, you're invincible, you can still drown and get crushed though, and it takes longer depending on how many rings you have. More box areas, woohoo. but I promise you, I'm pretty sure this is the last one. We're actually pretty close to the end. It's not too long of a zone, it's very user-friendly, pretty fun. Next up comes the Labyrinth Zone, which that one's actually probably the hardest zone in Sonic the Hedgehog history, I would have to say. Okay, maybe not that hard, but it's pretty difficult. There's lots of water. I'll be accepting level challenges, but try not to make them too difficult because that is a pretty tricky zone. It involves a lot of water, so be creative. Anyways, this is the third appearance of Dr. Robotnik with his spike weapon. And this is annoying for multiple reasons. First, if you didn't notice already, he'll take away floor tiles. And if you fall in there, you will instantly die because it's a pit. You actually can hit him while he moves around, but has a very small hit radius, like you see there. And because of my challenge, I need to finish with at least 20 rings, so if I get hit by him, I basically have to start over. But he's really not too hard to kill, you just gotta avoid falling the pits. And that was the end of my third video, kind of shorter than the previous one, but again, it's not too long of a zone. Labyrinth Zone's up next, if you have challenges, leave them below. If you also want to hear discussion topics about Sonic the Hedgehog, you can leave those as well. Thank you so much for watching, guys, you're all awesome, I'll see you later.